I feel a little more like watching my back here at the Orleans. What up? It's the Trooper. Random Monday on the Strip. Actually, it's not that random. It's November 27th. November 27th, Strip action. I think I'm in the mood for a burger.
Are these lemons real?
No, not real. I'm in the mood for a burger, y'all. Alright, I was looking for a burger. Posh Burger delivers. I don't mean they deliver it. I mean they deliver on the burger. No, it's dark outside now. Looking for some action. I think I'm gonna go play somewhere that I haven't played in a really long time. It could probably be considered local poker, but it's very close to the Strip. But first, coffee. Looking for that coffee burn? I found it. Let's go play poker. Interesting story, by the way, from Las Vegas. Tuesday, that would be tomorrow, the city council is gonna propose or vote or something. The proposal is to create some sort of ordinance that prevents people from stopping on the pedestrian bridges. Did you see the guy on my way across? He was playing, I don't know what the hell he was playing, I didn't pay attention, but he was playing an instrument. That would be outlawed by this ordinance. I don't know what the real purpose is. I don't know if they're targeting street performers or if they're targeting CD hustlers or if they're targeting, three card Monty shell game scammers. I don't know what the real purpose is, but I do know that if you come to Vegas as a tourist, and you want to stop and take a picture or a video, a pedestrian bridge is one of the most popular places to do that. Because of that, I think it's kind of dumb. However, it's my belief that they're going to make an ordinance that they do not enforce or that they selectively enforce. They'll probably kick people with speakers and PAs and shit like that off the bridge. But if a guy stops to take a picture, they probably won't do anything. It'll just be another city ordinance like no glass containers out on the Strip or whatever. You know, when I cash out chips and leave the casino and walk out into the parking lot here at the Orleans, I'm reminded of my comments at Boulder Station the other night when I said that it was located in a less desirable part of town. But I gotta tell you, I feel a little more like watching my back here at the Orleans than I did at Boulder Station. There's just a weird feeling over here. I don't know what street this is right here, but Tropicana is the main road out front of Orleans. And this area of Tropicana is known for street prostitutes and who knows what else. And so, I mean, Boulder Highway is known for all kinds of scummy activity. There's an Emerald Suites Weekly Motel or Hotel. Can't tell if it's a hotel or a motel. Looks like a motel. What is the difference? I usually consider the difference to be having doors to the rooms that are that go straight outside rather than being inside through a main door and then through hallways. Whatever. As far as the poker goes, some of the faces are strip regular faces. A lot of the faces are just old, angry faces. And I think Orleans has kind of a reputation for that. I remember not too long ago, I remember not too long ago that the rake here was 3-2. And then I think at some point it was 4-1. I'm not really sure. But I do remember that it was 3-2 for a while. It is 5-2 now. So the rake here at Orleans is the same as any strip property that has promotions. Orleans is known for having a shit ton of promotions. Bad Beats, football, hot seat, you know, quads and progressive this and that and all kinds of shit, right? So it's a very pokery poker room, and the entire end of the casino where the poker room is, like, there's a whole area with empty tables, I guess, for tournaments or whatever. There's a bar there and a food court that has like Fuddruckers and Sparrow. So nothing too exciting there. There's like a fake Starbucks on the other end, on the east end of the casino. And yeah, I don't know. It's a locals joint near the strip. Oh, I end up losing. This is the worst part of all. I end up losing to these numbskulls. What was the number? 233? Yeah, I'm down 233. But I've been here long enough. Can't take it anymore. I was in a 1-2 game. They have 1-2 and they have one table of 2-3. But according to one of the dealers, this is the last day of 1-2 and 2-3. According to the dealer, tomorrow they change the games they spread to 1-3 and 2-5. According to a dealer. So, I don't know. Take that for whatever you will. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos. I'll leave a comment down below. And if I didn't have this rear view mirror to help me watch my back, just watch your back. I'll see you next time.